my dimension, trouble was just a memory. Years had passed with no intergalactic activity. I'd retired from tripping with alien epiphanies. No foreign entities or spirits had come to visit me. Then just as I turned in for the evening, I saw vividly a female form appeared over my bed and blew a kiss at me. I was in a remote location, nobody lives with me. Raised up instantly, trying to figure out who this could be. A breeze blew through the room so cold that I began to shiver. She whispered softly in my ear and told me to come hither. In other words, come with her. Said she'd been waiting all day. I followed her as she levitated down my hallway. She was close to me, but still somehow I couldn't touch her. I salivated over her anatomical structure as she floated so gracefully, waving her hands, luring me, caressing me from a distance and constantly assuring me. My guard's totally down now. I'm dazing in the zone, not even seeming to care that this stranger was in my home. Her mouth's not even moving, but somehow the words were spoken through. I looked below my feet, then realized that I was floating too. Asked her who she was because her whole aura compelled me. She told me once we reached our destination, she would tell me. I followed willingly, somehow knowing she wouldn't hurt me. She said that if you want me, you must prove yourself worthy. I didn't even question it, I knew that could be foolish. But I'm up for any challenge, whatever you say, I'll do it. She said I knew it, and that's when I landed back on my feet. At that moment, the gaping hole opened up underneath. Heard sweet melodies playing as I dropped 1,000 feet. Landed perfectly on a comfortable plush-like leather seat. Again, I asked her, who are you? Because I think that I'm in love with you. Opened her hands and in her palm was written LW. It was in that moment that I knew somehow we were compatible. I'd be happy to embark upon an eternal sabbatical with L-Dub. Her spell was so real, I can't tell it. Hard to even spell it. Her facial features were angelic. So when we make conversation, she locks me in a deep state, in a place where we mentally connect for about a week straight. And every day I found myself hoping, wishing, assuming that this would be the moment we consummate our union. Then one day she came to me and told me it was time now. Her flesh became real. I asked and she said, never mind how. She whispered, are you ready? I said, yeah, I'm coming at you. Finally about to touch her, as I reached out, someone snatched her.
Whoa, what just happened? Whoa, hold up.
Where's she? Baby, where are you?
Oh, no.
First my rhyme books, now my woman. The spot that she stood in was real hot and smoking. I was choking while yelling out, baby, stop joking. Gone with no trace, no clue, no token. I ran through the house, the back door was wide open. Her scream was so alarming that I knew she was in torment. I found the document in the right pocket of her garment. It was a personal letter specifically for me, but it wasn't new, it was dated 2003. It said in the event that someone would ever take me, I placed on his paper instructions on how to save me. The letter was so precise, I was taken back abruptly as I thought, should I trust this? The next line said, trust me, you have all the clues that you need to help me escape. As I'm thinking, what clues? The next line said, in the safe. Now I'm tripping to know how this was happening. I didn't list in things that were non-existent when this letter was written. I sprang into action, absent of hesitation. There was a map in the safe that showed the location. It highlighted the top of 1,000-mile mountain. I climbed it and entered the cave next to the fountain. The info that she left me in the safe was all valid. The second I entered the cave, turned into a palace, immaculate, full of magic, majestic as the moon. All gold with at least 250 rooms. After 2 hours of searching, I had seen nothing at all. Then in a soft, sweet voice, my name was being called. I knew it was L-Dub, so I chased the sound blindly. But every time I got close, I heard the voice behind me. Then to the left, then to the right, I felt like a buffoon. Every door I opened, the voice moved to a different room. I was being fooled, all the running around was making me weaker. Heard a dark, evil laugh come over the loudspeaker. It said, I know who you're after, so you better move faster. I plan to marry you, but if you find her, you can have her. I said, show yourself. He said, I will before the night's done. Until then, you can search the rooms and try to find the right one. Her voice was still calling, not stopping, but it might soon. Exhausted as I reached the 249th room. But when I opened 250, my brain cells collided. The last door was a room that had the other rooms inside it. I knew I had to do something now I'd never done. Each door flew open and there she stood in every one. Some type of gun lowered down to me from the top. Then the evil voice said, Kareno, I'll give you one shot. I quickly knew that I was now dangling on a limb. Every image of her quickly changed to an image of him. Did I think I had any hope after that? No, I don't. He was too horrible to try to describe, so I won't. He said, shoot your only shot, and if you strike the right image, I'll be destroyed and this entire challenge will be finished. A 1 in 249 chance, this is crazy. There was one clue remaining on a sheet that she had gave me. I looked at it and said, hell no, something has gone wrong. It was a picture of me with a weapon to my own dome. If this is what she meant, she put a shady spin on it. Maybe this is all just a trick and she was in on it. That couldn't be true, the perfect chemistry we had found it. So I had to trust her no matter how crazy it sounded. I placed the weapon to my head and let the bullet fly out. He cried out and each image of him began to die out. I noticed that the whole place was consumed with fumes, and a body laid at the threshold of one of the rooms. The wicked one was wiped out, his corpse was on the ground. Then L-Dub emerged in a long, beautiful gown. I asked her how we make it when I'm knowing that I sprayed it though. She said I placed an invisible shield around us days ago. The first time I showed up at your house and you were sleeping, see? Then I came and deactivated his shield secretly. Then I asked who was he, she said never mind softly. He's been chasing me for 3 millenniums and finally caught me. I knew you were the one to save me, I'm happy he's gone. What took so long? She said I had to wait for you to be born. I finally held her in my arms, carried her away, and then we walked out of the castle and it turned into a cave again. Permanently branded, our thoughts running concurrently, granted me the power to travel with her eternally. I had one more question, she said yes, what is it? By the way, what's L-Dub? She whispered, Lady Wizard. Now I get it, and I'm seeing things I never saw before. Wow, in seconds we were at my home. Time to close the door now. It's time to close the door now. No, for real, time to close the door now. Y'all can go. Get out. The story's over.